Have you ever watched a movie or TV show and wondered, how does that technology work?
Oh, I'm more than interested.
Look, I don't pretend to know how the Tesseract or the AllSpark actually work, but I know a blockchain when I see one. We can learn a lot from fiction and how it relates to the very real world of blockchains and cryptocurrencies. This is the Blockchains of Black Mirror, presented by MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. Let's get into my favorite episode of the series, Nosedive. We follow our hero, Lacey Pound, as she strives to reach five-star status, along with millions of other people who are now subject to an all-permeating rating system. In this system, people rate each other based on their interactions with one another. Positive interaction, good rating.
Did we just become best friends?
Yep!
Negative interaction, well...
Two stars?
So what does your rating affect in this Black Mirror world? Lots of things. Whether you get favors, like free cookies, free smoothies, or free croissants. It also affects whether you don't get favors.
Slow down. Let's give her a ride.
She's like 2.8.
Come on!
It determines credits and discounts.
Hit 4.5 and there's a 20% discount.
Blights.
I'm a 4.2. Mm-mm.
I'm afraid you're actually a 4.18.
Car rentals.
You're restricted to our Super Saver fleet. iCruiser 2.
They still have the 2?
And wedding invitations.
I don't know what is up with you, but I cannot have a 2.6 at my wedding.
And let's just say the system doesn't treat Lacey super well. Oh yeah, the rating also affects whether you can keep your job, secure a home, or even receive access to cutting-edge cancer treatment.
Tom was a 4.3. They gave his bed to a 4.4.
It's a pretty bleak setup, I admit, but I just can't help myself. When I look back on this episode and rating system, I see one thing and one thing only, blockchain.
I do not mean that how it sounds.
Now, I'm not saying blockchains are so great and so this Black Mirror system is so great and let's all make it happen. Keep in mind, Black Mirror is designed to warn us and highlight cautionary tales as we attempt to use technology to make the real world a better place. Blockchain technology is, at its core, merely a tool, neither good nor evil. It's what we do with it that matters. Let's take a close look at this fictional society and system and discover why it's very likely to be a blockchain. I may have spoken too soon when I said that the system in Black Mirror is fictional. According to Wired.com, the Chinese government began discussing a similar concept back in 2007. A key difference, though, between the Chinese system and the Black Mirror system is that it appears that the authorities are the primary magistrates of the Chinese system. The article states, quote, "Authorities make deductions for bad behavior like traffic violations and add points for good behavior such as donating to charity," end quote. The Black Mirror system appears to be very different in this regard. The woman you accidentally spilled coffee on or the taxi driver who downvoted you on the way to the airport have the power to tip the scales against you when rebooking your flight. In the Black Mirror system, it's individuals that are judge, jury, and executioner when it comes to social credit. The Black Mirror system is much more peer-to-peer. And do you know what else is peer-to-peer? Blockchain. I don't believe the Black Mirror system is run by any centralized government structure that we are familiar with today, which is important to mention in the case for blockchain. The government is strangely absent from the episode, almost too absent.
Sure is quiet out there.
Too quiet.
The only government clues we see in the episode are this guy, who is airport security, and these two people, who appear to be detention officers. While this airport security guy looks intimidating, his shoulder patch does not indicate any type of government organization, such as the TSA. It's just a generic symbol of a plane and the generic word security. So this guy could easily be employed by a private security company. According to this 2016 Marketplace article, San Francisco and 21 other airports have privatized their security. Same goes for prisons. According to a 2013 report by the U.S. Department of Justice, 8.4% of the overall prison population were housed in private prisons. That isn't to say, though, that the Black Mirror world is some anarchy devoid of any authority. In fact, we can see the American flag in this shot right here. But that doesn't mean it's the same America we know today. It's possible that the US government may have been entirely replaced by a blockchain-based system. I know I'm starting to sound like these people look, a little ridiculous, but just stick with me during these next few parts.
Sure, okay.
In the episode, we see airport security impose harsher penalties than a simple one-star rating.
I'm invoking my authority as airport security to dock you one full ranking point as a punitive measure. Please, remove yourself from the airport immediately.
If the Black Mirror system is a blockchain, how did airport security gain the authority to do this? The answer may lie in decentralized governance, a concept often practiced in blockchain networks today. The airport authority can draft a proposal to the blockchain network, asking for special powers. These powers can be exercised on travelers located within the geofence, or GPS zone of the airport. The proposal is then reviewed by participants on the network. Voting occurs on the blockchain, and the proposal is denied or approved. So it may not have been the government that granted this authority within the rating system, but the participants of the system themselves. Blockchain-based voting has often been discussed for years, with more attention brought to it more recently. According to this GovTech article, a Utah resident became the first person to use Votes, a mobile voting app powered by blockchain technology, to cast a vote for president during the 2020 election. Is it so much of a stretch for a blockchain to become the government? Maybe not.
Would you like to know more?
There is a sovereign state called Liberland, located between Croatia and Serbia right now. What makes Liberland special is that according to this Breaker Mag article, the official currency is the Merit, a cryptocurrency stablecoin pegged to the US dollar.
Are you sure?
Yeah. And the article also states that Liberland will govern itself through blockchain. Liberland is real. It has a flag. It has a president. It has a passport. But to be officially recognized, it needs recognition from five other sovereign states. Liberland does have a long way to go towards full recognition.
How long do you think?
I have no idea, but the fact remains, currently there is already a real sovereign state where the government is a blockchain.
Sounds awesome.
If we can accept that the Black Mirror system is not run by a government, the next question is it run by a corporation? The Black Mirror system, that's just a Facebook and Yelp merger, right? Not so fast.
I'll show you.
Check out the documentary Billion Dollar Bully about Yelp on Amazon Prime Video. For business owners and operators, Yelp is arguably worse than the mafia. Yelp is arguably worse than that. Yelp is even arguably worse than that. Oh, but I'm sure Yelp has their own side of the story.
This man accosted me! You are all witnesses he accosted me!
Even though I'd rather sleep with the fishes than deal with Yelp, they did technically have a system where you could appeal to them for reviews you felt were inaccurate or abusive. Yelp is centralized, and Yelp has the power to delete reviews. My main argument here for the Black Mirror system being a blockchain protocol and not a platform wholly owned by a corporation is that there appears to be no centralized appeals process in this system. A rating transaction executed by a person appears to be final. Binding and unalterable.
I didn't even do anything!
This is a well-known trait of blockchains, immutability. Barring any unique specifications, when you execute a transaction on a blockchain, it can't be undone. It's gonna be there
forever. Forever. Forever.
In Black Mirror, there doesn't seem to be a singular company that has the power to do things like delete ratings. I'm reminded of recent news when Google deleted nearly 100,000 one-star reviews of the Robinhood app on the Google Play Store, according to this article from The Verge.
We fixed the glitch.
This was in the wake of Robinhood halting trading of GameStop stock after a massive short squeeze took place. And there's a lot of controversy surrounding Robinhood's decision.
Now, I used to work in finance, so I know this stuff, but the audience doesn't need to. The New York Stock Exchange does. So if anybody was going to control the listing and shut it down, It should have been them, but it wasn't. It was you.
If the Google Play Store were decentralized, those reviews would have been far harder to censor and remove, which leads me to believe that in Black Mirror, there is no corporation that controls the system. Oh, but hold on, you say. Earlier in the episode, Lacey visits what looks like a corporate facility to see all kinds of data about her ratings and circle of influence. The company Reputelligent must be the company who builds, maintains, and controls the system, right? While Lacey does visit Reputelligent, it's only to receive consulting services on how to improve her score. There's no evidence that they have any control or power over the system. When she is denied her flight, she doesn't contact Reputelligent to dispute her rating. To me, Reputelligent appears to be nothing more than a third-party consulting firm. Lacey hired Reputelligent to help improve her personal brand. The network itself and the companies that maintain it, interact with it, and design business models around it are separate. And some people will always struggle with understanding this. A blockchain protocol sits underneath the front-end user interface, which can be supplied by any number of companies that use the same protocol. A great example of this is the Hive blockchain, which directly stores user-generated content, such as articles, comments, and curations.
It's pretty good.
Now, there is a user interface called Hive.blog, which accesses the blockchain database of content and shows it on your screen. However, there is another user interface called PeakD that accesses the same exact blockchain database and shows the same exact data on your screen with PeakD's unique design and style. You see, the blockchain is owned by no single entity. It's just a protocol.
Do you own the sand and the water? Nobody owns the water. It's God's water.
If you send a Bitcoin transaction to the wrong address by mistake, there is no Bitcoin company incorporated that can step in and undo your transaction for you.
And it's gone.
If a software development foundation releases a new version of code for a blockchain network, the network operators, which are spread out throughout the world, have the power to accept or reject the new code. The blockchain network is self-governing.
Apes together, strong!
We learned a lot about blockchains in this dystopian example of society, but that's just background. This episode of Black Mirror raises some huge questions about censorship and freedom of expression in the foreground. Behavioral engineering and game theory have created a type of mob censorship where you are judged and punished by the mob. It's less like government censorship, or even censorship by companies such as Twitter, who banned the former president of the United States, and more like cancel culture, a modern form of ostracism in which someone is thrust out of social or political circles, either online, in the real world, or both, according to Wikipedia.
We finally canceled culture. That was the last thing left for us at Cancel Culture to cancel. We think we've made society a much better place by erasing all culture from it. Now that we've cleansed society of everything that could possibly challenge you in some way, it's finally safe to be happy.
Why risk making a joke, creating a song, or starting a business if people who don't like it have the power to completely ruin your life? For more on cancel culture, mob censorship, and how freedom of expression is affected, check out the documentary, Can We Take a Joke, on Amazon Prime Video.
There's a lot of people out there whose job it is to be offended for other people.
It's almost like people have gotten soft.
The world of Nosedive in Black Mirror has become terrifyingly gentrified.
Great job.
Oh, I am sorry, but I miss the normal you.
And we can see it everywhere. Check out what all these total strangers are wearing at the airport. Everyone has converged on singular fashion choices that offend the least amount of people. Freedom of expression has all but disappeared.
You're so right, it's gone.
You don't want to be denied a bank loan just because people didn't like your shirt, do you? So there you have it. For better or worse, the rating system in Black Mirror is a blockchain. Let's use the episode for its intended purpose, though, to warn us what can happen if we're not careful with new and powerful technology. Blockchain is just a tool, like any other. And it's up to us to enhance society with it in a way that benefits us the most. Share this video with a Black Mirror fan near you.
Are you kidding? Of course.
And subscribe to the video channel of MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. See you next time.